The MD5 and SHA-1 HTTP digest mechanisms have been disabled by default, as these algorithms have weaknesses. Say goodbye to parsing of encoded values in your application code when using getSubject alternative names and the getIssue alternative names methods of the X509 certificate class. JDK 19 brings a few cool features to the beloved jarsigner tool. Oh, Valentine's Day, time for candy, presents, and job application security. Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Anna Maria Michalciano, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and today we're going to take a closer look at several Java security improvements on cryptography, PKI, TLS, and more. Yeah, all the good stuff that we love to investigate in order to pass vulnerability assessments, penetration tests, and security audits. But don't worry, this episode will bring some happiness to all of you who have felt sad getting those emails containing summary of all issues and associated severity level of each finding, because Java is a safe language, and the Java platform has robust security capabilities like bytecode verification, runtime security checks, and built-in library-level security. So buckle up, and let's dive right in. If you're working on application features related to encryption or decryption, you are aware that these processes are based on publicly available algorithms, but access to the data is obtained using a secured key. If you do not specify a key size when using a key pair generator or key generator object to generate a key pair or secret key, the JDK provider will use a provider-specific default value. To meet security standards, starting with JDK 19, default key sizes have been increased as follows. For RSA, RSA, SSA, PSS, and DH algorithms, the default size has been increased from 2048 bits to 3072 bits. For the EC algorithm, the default size has been increased from 256 bits to 384 bits. For the AS algorithm, the default size has been increased from 128 bits to 256 bits, if permitted by the crypto policy. Otherwise, the default falls back to 128 bits. Speaking of security providers, the JDK SAM provider SHA-3 message digest algorithm performance has been increased up to 2 times. More secure by default. That's cool. Okay. Let's slow down a bit. The security landscape evolves continuously. For example, stronger algorithms are introduced while older ones are deemed less secure. And that's why in JDK 19, several deprecations occurred as well. OIP parameter spec.default got deprecated because this constant uses default algorithms that have weakened. Applications should avoid using this constant, and instead, they should explicitly define the parameters of OIP parameter spec constructor. PSS parameter spec int and PSS parameter spec.default are deprecated also because they are using default algorithms that have weakened. Applications should avoid using these constants, and instead they should explicitly define the parameters of PSS parameter spec constructor. Also, the MD5 and SHA-1 HTTP digest mechanisms have been disabled by default, as these algorithms have weaknesses. You could still re-enable them, but that's at your own risk, via a new system property named re-enabled algorithms. The JDK is updated regularly to cope with changes in the security realm and keep the Java platform secure. Make sure to check the Oracle JDK cryptographic roadmap, as it reflects the latest changes applied to the security providers shipped by Oracle in the Oracle JDK. Probably already use public key infrastructure PKI when dealing with digital certificates, so you'll be happy to hear about the enhanced support for other names types in X509 certificates. Say goodbye to parsing of encoded values in your application code when using getSubject alternative names and the getIssue alternative names methods of the X509 certificate class. More good news if you're using the SunMSC API provider to access native cryptographic libraries, certificate stores, and key containers on Windows. Probably you noticed that only certificates available to user accounts are listed when using Windows My or Windows Root. Windows My Local Machine and Windows Root Local Machine key store types were added to provide access to keys and certificates stored on the Windows operating system that are available to all accounts. Now, I can't imagine that you're worried about using Windows My and Windows Root, so let me clarify this for you. To avoid confusion, Windows My current user and Windows Root current user names have been added, and they map to Windows My and Windows Root respectively. All these changes are documented in the JDK provider's guide, and you can find it in the links attached to this episode. Do you wonder if there are any enhancements regarding transport layer security? Well, of course there are. To speed up and reduce the amount of memory used during a TLS handshake, JDK 19 introduced several TLS performance-related improvements. Cache certificates decoded from TLS session tickets, avoid evaluating SSL algorithms constraint twice, caching of the results for constraint checks. If you're like me and have this concern that you will accidentally enable deprecated or unsafe features, you'll be happy to hear about these. 3DES suits are removed from default enables DLS cipher suits. This was done because the strength of 3DES is 112 bits, which is less than the 128 bits required by RFC 7525. Check out the JDK 19 release notes to find out more. The JDK 20 Early Access release notes, still subject to change until the final release next month, mentioned that DTLS 1.0 is disabled by default because the EETF has deprecated this version. Similarly, TLS ECDH cipher suits are disabled as they do not preserve forward secrecy and they are rarely used in practice. Historically speaking, jarsigner is the most convenient tool that you can use to sign and verify Java archive files. JDK 19 brings a few cool features to the beloved jarsigner tool. You can now add a minus provider path option and use it to specify the class by the funAlternate key store implementation. This one even works with the minus provider class option. The default digest algorithm when signing jar files with jarsigner has been changed from SHA-256 to SHA-384. The default signature algorithms used when signing jar files with jarsigner have been strengthened. This change is reflected in the supported algorithms section of the jarsigner specification. You know that saying, give candy and a reminder about algorithms considered a security risk? Well, I just invented that. But you should be aware that keytool will now emit warnings if you use RC2 and ARC4 algorithms in any commands associated with secret key entries of a key store. That is because RC2 and ARC4 have been added to the legacy algorithm security property in the Java security configuration file. Keytool will also emit warnings if keys or certificates use any of the DES, DESCD, and MD5 algorithms, and as they are also added to the legacy algorithm security property. If you take a look at the JDK 20 Early Access release notes, you'll notice that a new Java Flight Recorder JFR event named Initial Security Property enabled by default has been added to record the details of initial security properties when loaded via the security class. The other new JFR event is Security Provider Service and has been added to record details about provider.getService calls. This event is disabled by default, but you can still enable it via JFR configuration files or standard JFR options. And that's it for today on the Inside Java Newscast. Since you made it all the way to the end, please do me a favor and hit that like button. Also, subscribe, click the bell, share this video with your friends and enemies. Newscasts will be coming every 2 weeks, and the next one will be hosted by my colleague Nikolai Parlog. See you soon!